Canadian stocks the lowest since 2016. And of course, there are a lot of economic analysts that are predicting that we could be into a slowdown that'll last about 18 months. And I would imagine that's pretty devastating when it comes to the demand for energy. What happens if you own energy stocks?
Canadian energy stocks are certainly in between a rock and a hard place here. The whole environment changed over the weekend when Russia decided to leave OPEC Plus, an agreement that they had with the OPEC nations to kind of be a part of the consortium of producers there. So Saudi Arabia wanted to cut $1 billion of daily production. Russia decided that they weren't going to do their part and kind of backed off. In consequence, Saudi Arabia came back and said they're going to increase production overnight. And on Monday, we saw both the energy sector as well as equities be roiled by that news. And now we're trading below $30 WTI. So it's going to be a tough time for Canadian energy producers, particularly those that are highly levered on their balance sheet, as the banking system is going to be a little bit more stringent to lend in this environment.
Airline stocks also down. Air Canada saying they're down about 62% since the beginning of the year. What if you own airline stocks?
You know, we've seen further and further reductions in planned trips. WestJet today just announced that they're basically shutting down international travel with remaining open and aiding in government response efforts. Air Canada, similar type of measures, as well as being very accommodative to customers, allowing for free cancellation and changes. That has been reflected in their share price. The problem with the airline industry is it's a very operationally capital intensive business. So despite the fact that they have cheaper input costs on fuel, some of which they've hedged away, which is not great for them, it's going to be a tough time for them as capacity rates fall. Both the Canadian and U.S. government, even to quote Mr. Trump just a second ago, saying that it's not their fault. They're there to help the airline system. And I think the government's support will be there to make sure that there is some help. But for equity holders, it's probably still a bit early and a bit of a dangerous time to go to what would be the blast center of one of the hardest hit industries out there right now.
Given the scope of the market, I mean, should you be rebalancing? Should you be selling, or should you just be staying put?
It depends on the type of investor you are. If you're a long-term investor that works with a financial advisor or just makes an annualized or a contribution on a biweekly or monthly basis, steadfast. If you have any extra money, you know, it's TFSA and RRSP time, it would probably be a good time to put some in. I wouldn't be confident to say that the market's reached its lows. For active traders like ourselves, it's presented tremendous opportunities, and we continue to reposition our portfolios. Within our core income equity fund, which is North American dividend paying stocks, we're looking for companies that are maybe opportunistically, I hate to use that word during these times, but in a position to see either stable or increasing demand. Conversely, trimming companies that would be harder hit should this prolong longer than people are expecting.
I want to pick up on something that you just said, that you don't think we've seen the lows yet. So if we haven't hit the bottom yet, what can you sort of look back on historically that will give us an indication of where that bottom is?
So we use a variety of correction indicators. Sentiment readings are one of them. We actually haven't seen sentiment completely capitulate. You know, viewers or listeners or readers of the media that the Financial Post produce would probably agree that there's still a lot of people out there saying, you know, this is a buying opportunity. What can I buy? When you think back to the 08 crisis, we saw money market purchases of money market skyrocket and purchases of equities and fixed income all go into redemption. So we haven't seen that pure capitulation sign yet. Secondly, you know, you think back to the airlines. Air Canada was trading at a dollar something back during the financial crisis. The American airlines were all literally going bankrupt, needing bailouts. We're still not there. There's, you know, they've lost 50% of their value, but they're still 50% higher than zero. So we haven't seen that pure flush out from the sentiment side. And the problem is with what the president, social media, and other popular media sources are telling us is I think people think this is a bit transitory. The effects, if deemed necessary for longer, will re-rate stocks lower. Combine that with earnings and estimates from companies coming out over the coming weeks, there could be some more bad news ahead.
So what should you be buying, and conversely, what should you be selling?
So we think it's too early to enter into the most cyclical parts of the market. Conversely, the other thing is to check the balance sheets and financial stability of companies. Maintaining ownership in high quality corporations. We like some grocery stores, some technology companies. Last time we were on, I talked about a position we had made into Clorox. You know, things that are opportunistically going to benefit here in the short term that are going to be mandated to remain open seem like safer bets than trying to reach for an airline or an energy exploration and production company at this time. On the flip side, when things do recover, they will give you the highest torque, the ones that got closest to the brink. So just about kind of calling the bottom. And for a retail client, I think staying steadfast and, you know, on the edges, putting cash to work or trimming your bonds in favor of equities is also a prudent decision.
How much cash should you be sitting on as a percentage of your portfolio?
So it depends on your personal situation. But what I would say is if you did have an overweight cash position like we had kind of coming into this, we've already made one deployment, I would say about of a third of that cash. You know, if you've got off a third or 50% of it by this point, I think that's reasonable. But I'd leave a few bullets in the chamber to give yourself the opportunity if you get even more attractive valuations on some high quality names. And then even when that cash runs out, if you have been quick to act, there'll be opportunities to rotate into specific areas of opportunity as they continue to present themselves.